As for the registrable rights, such as patents, trademarks, and registered designs, these should be filed where possible, as they are more certain to exist if you once you've filed them. Whether they're valid or not is a separate question. And they often last longer than the unregistered rights. For example, in the EU and the UK, registered designs can last up to 25 years compared to 15 years for unregistered design rights or 3 years for community unregistered design rights. And they can be filed for the external appearance of the camera and for the graphical user interface of the app. Further, registered trademarks should be secured, of course, for the company name and any catchphrases or other branding that they use. As for patent protection, that might be possible for the overall system because it's nice and simple compared to the prior art systems. The main ones that we see in use amongst pros would be OptiShot and TrackMan. They instead use IR infrared sensors in a mat. So as the club swings over the top, it senses the club. And the TrackMan version uses a dual radar system in a dedicated visualization panel that sits behind the ball and again inspects what the club's doing. Because of the similarities, the prior art effect of these may also make the patents difficult to obtain. Novelty will exist in software, but the software structure and the business model that the app's then enabling are likely to be much harder to protect with a patent because software and business methods are typically non-patentable in Europe. However, if there's something technical about these, so if somehow the software is interacting with the equipment to make things work more quickly than was previously possible, then there could be something patentable there.